What is up, alien army? I am Oculus, the alien next door, purveyor of esoteric lore. And today, our esoteric topic, we are going to be talking about draconic astrology. So let's get into it, shall we? Now, to first understand draconic astrology, one must know that it contains the same zodiac signs as the traditional or tropical zodiac chart. The difference is, instead of using the sun's position point of 0 degrees Aries, the draconic system will always use the moon's nodes as 0 degrees Aries for the north node and 0 degrees Libra for the south node. This will be true for every draconic chart, although the other placements may change. The north and south lunar nodes, astrologically speaking, are reflective of past lives and the lessons the soul chose to learn during their lifetime now. As the sun in astrology represents the ego or outer persona of the self, the soul represents the inner sphere of one's existence. Draconic astrology, in essence, focuses on the personality of the soul, to put it simply. Utilizing the placements of one's draconic chart in tandem with one's tropical zodiac natal chart can give more depth and insight in what the soul chose to experience in this lifetime. It is somewhat like the inner compass or guidance system which leads that individual towards fulfilling their destiny. The nodes in draconic astrology are referred to as Caput Draconis and Cauda Draconis. Yeah, I pronounced those really weird, but whatever. Sometimes referred to as the head and tail of the dragon. The dragon's head is hungry for more, whilst the tail is releasing what it has experienced before. This is why the lunar nodes showcase what the soul chose to build upon in this lifetime, and also what they wish to shed. The lunar nodes in all versions of astrology are always an axis of opposing signs. The south node is what one is familiar with, as they have lived a lifetime or so under the influence of these characteristics, so these traits will feel somewhat natural for the native. The north node is what the soul has chosen to learn in this lifetime, as it will essentially be uncharted territory for them, energetically speaking. This is why the draconic chart begins at the zero point of the north node and not the zero point of the sun. It is focusing on the journey of the soul rather than the journey of the ego. Soul being lunar, moon, inner realm. Ego being sun, solar, outer realm. The draconic astrological chart is meant to represent the personality of the soul before it incarnated into a physical body. This is who the native is at their core. It is the energetic frequency of their soul. This is the eternal essence of who they are, underneath the guise of the ego. When interpreting a draconic chart, it is advised to view it along with the tropical zodiac chart because the draconic placements will provide insight into what is going on with the ego. Utilizing one's draconic placements can help to understand the ego, quote-unquote, personality better, and can also show how the individual's soul blends with their ego self. The draconic chart is a great tool when working on the shadow aspect of the individual. It will show harmonious liaisons betwixt one's tropical and draconic placements, as well as potential discrepancies. One example of how to utilize the draconic chart is to compare it to the tropical natal chart. Perhaps look at them both side by side. Let's say someone has their tropical moon sign in Cancer and their draconic moon sign in Libra. Both placements are still showing how the individual will respond internally and emotionally. However, their draconic moon in Libra will be the soul's response to emotions, whereas the tropical moon will be the personality's response to emotions. In the case of Cancer and Libra, The personality moon, Cancer, will respond in a Cancerian nature, whilst the soul moon will respond in a Libra nature. So, regarding both of these placements may awaken the native to an unseen aspect of themselves regarding emotional responses. This is why sometimes people don't fully resonate with their tropical placements. Their draconic placement of the same celestial body, in this case the moon, may be of an entirely different nature. We encourage you to explore both of your charts, as this may bring awareness to hidden soul urge aspects of yourself. In the case of the Cancer Moon, Libra Moon, it may be wise to tap into the positive qualities of Libra to help assist the personality traits of the Cancer Moon. The key is to blend the two signs together so that they are working in harmony with each other. Doing so will bring more peace and alliance betwixt what the personality wants and what the soul desires. Of course, there are also placements which you will find much resonance in between your tropical chart and draconic chart, and this would indicate that harmony in this area of your experience is quite prevalent within you. If you are interested in discovering your draconic chart placements, we will leave a link below so that you can get your draconic chart. And that is it for this brief intro for draconic astrology. It is always our intention that those who are meant to resonate with messages here do so well and receive them well. I am Oculus, the alien next door. We will chit-chat again soon. Peace, good vibes, and namaste blessed, because you are.